In the 1950s, a pair of American doctors ran human clinical trials in Puerto Rico to test the side effects of birth control pills. None of the women were told they were part of a clinical trial. Many of them were given 3 times the dose of present-day pills, and 3 women even died. The FDA didn't approve the pill in the United States until 1960. The eugenics movement pushed for mass sterilization of certain groups to help quote-unquote purify the American gene pool. The movement declined in popularity when Hitler started using similar tactics in his Final Solution, but there is actually documentation of Native American women being sterilized as late as the 1970s. In the early 1800s, there was a huge market for asylum tourism. The antebellum reformers pushed for citizens to visit asylums to help out and interact with the patients, but many historians argue that it turned into more of a zoo like atmosphere. So instead of helping, tourists would observe the strange behavior of the patients. J. Marion Sims is called the father of gynecology for perfecting various medical techniques in the field. But many people don't know, nor give credit to the slaves that he used as test subjects. Anarka, Betsy, and Lucy were 3 of these subjects, and their stories truly exemplify how many slaves are not given any recognition for their forced sacrifices in medical history. Little Albert was an infamous psychological experiment focusing on classical conditioning that placed a white rat in front of a 1-year-old child, and then made a very loud noise every time the child touched it. The baby quickly started crying every time he saw something white. Project MKUltra was a mind control program enacted by the CIA during the Cold War. The government tested the effects of drugs like LSD and even forms of torture on unwilling subjects in order to further their research. The Netflix show Stranger Things is loosely based on these experiments. The story of Henrietta Lacks has become much more widespread due to the creation of a book and a movie telling her story. She was a cancer patient who had her cells taken and harvested without her consent. The cells known as HeLa have helped cure diseases and advance stem cell research, but permission was never granted to use her cells, and many companies have made millions without any of that money going to her family. The Tuskegee experiment featured 600 black males, with 399 of them actually having syphilis. Many of the men were told that they were being treated for, quote, bad blood, but none of the individuals, including the 399 infected men, were given proper treatment for over 40 years.